I'm your host for today, KYX, also known as Kix2020. And quickly before the video starts, I just wanted to apologize for not being as consistent with my uploads. I should have just waited to upload the videos after I got back from the cabin, so I would have more time to edit them and make it the best quality I could put out. But instead, I jumped the gun and thought I could just start back up. Spoiler, I couldn't. So with all that being said, enjoy today's video. So for today's video, I am going to be ranking all of the 8 Spider-Man films from worst to best. Keep in mind that this video is solely based on my opinion, as well as facts about each movie that are online for the public to see. Also, by the way, real quick, I'm not counting movies like Venom or any of those, but I am counting movies like Into the Spider-Verse and those movies. Okay, last thing before the video starts, I promise. One of the influences for this video was the Business Insider article published in 2019. Link for that will be in the description down below if you want to read it before or after this video starts. So with everything being said, let's get straight into the rankings.
Number 8, The Amazing Spider-Man.
The Not-So-Amazing Spider-Man by director Mark Webb is by absolutely no means a great, heck, even good film. It is kind of just a lame excuse for Sony to keep the rights to the Spider-Man character. By the way, I'm not trying to hate on Andrew Garfield or director Mark Webb. There was just no reason to remake what Sam Raimi did so well with his 3 Spider-Man movies.
Number 7, The Amazing Spider-Man 2.
Nobody knows why director Mark Webb made this sequel, probably just to add a couple more zeros onto his bank account, to be honest. The reason I put this one higher than the first Amazing Spider-Man is because the movie didn't have enough villains, which the second movie exceeds at and fails simultaneously. Like I stated before, there is just no reason for the remakes. Sam Raimi did it better with his Spider-Man trilogy. That's all I'm saying.
Number 6, Spider-Man Homecoming.
In my opinion, Homecoming is almost the perfect depiction of Spider-Man as of late. As stated in the Business Insider article, Homecoming did what the Amazing Spider-Man failed to do, revive the franchise with a fresh take. And I completely 100% agree with them on that statement. The only reason I rank it lower than they do is because I feel as if Tom Holland's portrayal of the character was excellent. There are just some things he could have done to make the character more heroic. I am not hating on Tom Holland as Spider-Man. I love the way he brings a completely different take to the character, like no way we have seen the character before. Moving right along.
Number 5, Spider-Man 3. Alright, hold up. Before I show you guys the actual clip, here's just a quick little clip of the bloopers of this.
Very high hopes for our favorite Webster This is definitely a worse one. With the success of Sam Raimi's Spider-Man 1 and 2, audiences had very high hopes for our favorite Webster to cross paths with one of his oldest foes, Venom. And... nope. Although Venom was quite interesting in this movie,
insert transition here,
the way he moves, and well, that's pretty much it. The only really interesting part about Venom is the animalistic nature of him, the way he moves and grapples and grabs onto things. That's a very big change from the fluid-like motion of the comics. But stepping away from Venom for a second, you already know that we have to talk about this.
I'm gonna put some dirt in your eyes. Look at little Goblin Jr. Gonna cry?
You'll get your rent when you fix this damn door!
Emo Peter. There really isn't that much to say about him. He just kind of sucks, you know?
Number 4, Spider-Man. Just an okay movie with an okay storyline. Nothing really too groundbreaking. A straightforward story with minimal intricacies. Good villain arc, and just a good movie for its time, way before the MCU. Alright, here we go, moving into the big leagues now, number 3 with Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse. Into the Spider-Verse by Bob Bob is an amazing movie, especially for a franchise that has been rebooted and redone so many times. As they say in the movie,
alright people, let's do this one last time.
And Miles as a character is really amazing to watch, not only with the other spider people, but with the many villains in this movie. This movie felt like a comic book turned into a movie, which is precisely what it is. It's an amazing culmination of a bunch of spider people, as well as just an all-around good movie to watch if you're bored. Number 2, Spider-Man Far From Home. Being the latest installment of Spider-Man is hard, especially being the opening of a new phase for the MCU. After its predecessors, Avengers Endgame and Spider-Man Homecoming, people had extremely high hopes for this movie, and can I be the first to say, it delivers. It's so much better than Homecoming, the self-made hero turning himself into the Stark-powered mega machine known as Spider-Man. Peter leaves this movie shattered, his identity revealed, not knowing whether Quentin Beck is actually dead or not. And among other things, director John Watts made this movie so well, he took the loving care of Homecoming and tripled it. But most importantly, Tom Holland delivers on all of these emotions and basically the whole crowd's reaction to the end of this movie in one simple line. And now, the moment you've all been waiting for. Our number one spot of the best Spider-Man movie goes to. Yup, that's right, Spider-Man 2 by Sam Raimi. Both the Business Insider article and I agree on this one, and many other fans around the world. Spider-Man 2 by Sam Raimi was and always will be one of the most influential movies of all time. Great storytelling, an amazing character arc for Peter and MJ, a very cryptic ending, and many other things that this movie just did so right. You know that meme of Peter stopping the train and his face looks all like this? Yeah, that originated from this movie. Also, another point I want to stress is Alfred Molina as Doc Ock brings such an amazing take to the character that nobody ever has before. And that hospital scene, mwah. In my script here, it says French kiss motion. Yep, that makes sense. This movie, we had so many great elements from the first film and times it by over 10,000. There's so many great scenes, all the characters are amazing, and just the movie's great. That's all I have to say.
So as you can see, myself among many other people love the Spider-Man character. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. Leave a comment down below which Spider-Man is your favorite. And let me know how you feel about the Spider-Man character as a whole. Not just in the movies, but in games and other properties as well.
I just realized in my script I put in energetic voice for this part.
Make sure to drop a like on the video down below and subscribe for more videos like this one. This has been Kicks with your video, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Yay!